Hello everyone. Today I'm starting capital budgeting chapter. It is one of the very important concepts for the finance students. Whether you're doing BCom, MCom, MBA, BBA, any course, for finance students it is very important. And also this capital budgeting is included for the BTech students also, because tomorrow if they become a manager, they need to have a small understanding about what is capital budgeting, how we have to manage it, what are the concepts are included in this. That's the reason this, the chapter made it compulsory even for the non-commerce students also. Anyway, coming to this capital budgeting. Most of the companies, whenever they start their business, they'll be thinking at the, there'll be a dilemma that where to invest, which project is to be chosen, and which project will give the good benefits, and how we can utilize it in the maximum way. So what are the benefits of that? It's a dilemma thing for every organization. For that purpose, managing the capital and utilizing the capital in a proper way, so that in long term, so how we can utilize it and where we can invest it for long period and how we can get the benefits and which project, which investment will give us a good benefit, like all these things we'll be discussing into the capital budgeting. So a capital budgeting is justly simply for the long-term investments, long-term decisions. Anything you wanted to take it in long-term, for that purpose we use this capital budgeting. And finance manager, finance department, entire department will be working out and will be coming out with a good result of this capital budgeting. Where to invest, how much to invest, and how much return we are going to get. That is based on this capital budgeting. Let's see the definition of this capital budgeting. So capital budgeting, it's a technique used to evaluate those expenditure decisions. The benefits which occurs for more than 1 year. So capital budgeting is going to talk about those expenditure decisions where you are putting your investment more than 1 year, means long term. Below 1 year is short term, above 1 year is long term. Long term, whatever expenditure, whatever investments you are going to do, so that is going to discuss, that is going to convey in this capital budgeting. This is the definition, small definition. And let us see the needs and objectives of capital budgeting. So the main objectives or needs of this capital budgeting is, this first one is that long term decisions. Long term, whenever you want to take decisions, so how much you want to invest, where you want to invest, like long term. Long term is always we give preference, because in long term we'll have much risk. If long term decisions are not taken properly, the risk will become loss. Risk we take, but at the cost of benefit, at the cost of some uses. So that is why we have to take the decision, long term decisions in capital budgeting. And next objective is that progress. Every organization wants some progress. Without progress, they can't run, they can't exist, and they can't survive in the business. So that is why to have a progress, what we need to do, we have to utilize our finance properly. Utilizing our finance properly and where to invest. So this is the main content. So that is what we are discussing, to have a progress in any organization. So where to invest, how much finance we are having, and what is the right way of utilization. So that depends on the progress. So we'll be focusing on this area. And responsible for large amount of funds. So in capital budgeting, we are discussing about long term only. Long term amount investment. So this is responsible for large amount of funds. Short term amount of funds, we don't care. Because it's short term, it doesn't matter, and it doesn't affect much of the finance system or organizing system of any organization. That's why we are focusing only on the amount of funds, large amount of funds only. And next one, careful decisions. Here we have to take the decisions, proper decisions. We have to think, we have to revise, and we have to be very confident about the, such kind of decision. Then only we'll take the decision. That is why we say it as a careful decisions. Once if you take the decision, once if you implement it, once if you get a loss, then it is very difficult to recover the loss, and once again surviving in the cutthroat competitive world, it's very difficult. That is why careful decisions is one of the main objects of this capital budgeting. And last one is that identifying the effective proposal or project. Identifying effective proposal or project means here we'll have We'll find out wherever we want to put our investment in one proposal or one project. We'll be thinking that how many alternatives we are having. First, identifying all the alternatives, all the projects. Then after that, which one is best. So before going to the best, we have to identify. Unless we have a choice of 3 or 4, how can you choose it? So that is why the main objective is also to identify the different kinds of proposals or investment plans. So these are the main objectives of capital budgeting. Now we'll see the process. What is the process of this capital budgeting? So the main process or steps of capital budgeting is 5 stages. The first stage is this. First stage, second stage, third one, fourth one, and the fifth one. There are 5 steps or 5 stages of capital budgeting process. The first stage is what we are doing, identification of investment opportunities. We have to first identify the investment opportunities. Where we can invest, how much we can invest. This we have to find out. Who will find out this? Most of the time, finance manager who is having the authority, who have the command over the finance aspects and who have a good understanding about the finance system of the organization, this manager or these people, this department will be identifying the investment opportunity. How many investment opportunities we are having? So that we have to find out. Then after that, once if we finalize it, once if we identify, we'll go for the second step. The second step is that coordinating the investment proposals. Coordinating investment proposals, we have identified there. Now we have to coordinate each and every proposal. Means nothing but having more information, having a depth information, practical knowledge, or surviving or surveying related to this information, and having a good depth information about this, that is we call it as a coordinating the investment proposal. Once if you coordinate, once if you get a proper information, having a good understanding, then we can go for the third stage. So in the third stage, evaluation oblique analysis of investment proposal. This is very important, evaluation or analyzing the proposal. So which one is chosen, which one is recommended by the finance department, that is to be analyzed. Who has to analyze? Entire finance department, not by one person or two person. So entire department wise, step by step, the proposal can be observed and it can be properly evaluated. Then after that, they get an understanding. Once this evaluation is completed, then we can go for the fourth process, fourth step. So that is preparation of capital budgeting program. Evaluated, chosen a proper one, then preparing the capital budgeting program. So which program we wanted to go, capital budgeting, how much we wanted to invest, where to invest it, and in how many years we are going to get back, what would be the interest rate, like all these things, capital budgeting preparation will be preparing it. Once if this is finished, the last stage is implementation. We have to implement it. Implementation of investment proposal. Whatever we have taken the decision, that is to be implemented. And once if you implement it, means once if we are implementing it, we'll be getting profit or loss or neutral, break even or whatever it may be. So whatever may be the status, that has to be evaluated, that feedback has to be sent once again. So after this, we are going back, review and feedback of performance. How is this process, capital budgeting process, was it good? Any changes are to be made? Any amendments? Any kind of rectifications are to be done? So that everything we are going for the feedback of this process. This is called as process of capital budgeting. Let me give you a recap of this. So first, identifying the investment opportunities. What are the investment opportunities? First, identify. After identifying, coordinating the investment proposals by the finance manager with the finance department. Once if they investigate, then after that, evaluate analysis of investment proposal. Evaluate the proposal, whatever recommended in the second step. once if evaluation is over, preparing the capital budgeting preparation. Program is prepared, then after that implementation of investment proposal. After implementation, its progress, its work, its performance, whether good or bad, any kind of recommendations or suggestions to be given in the review and feedback of the performance to the, once again to the first process. So like we'll be going for the capital budgeting for long term investments point of view. Long term investment, because it's having a lot of risk in long term investments. So this is about the introduction of capital budgeting. In the coming classes, we'll work out a lot of problems related to the capital budgeting, like traditional methods, new techniques are there, very important problems, examination point of view especially. Whether you are doing BCom, MCom, MBA, BTech or anything, whatever may be the course, if you are having this capital budgeting chapter, definitely you can expect one problem, and problems are quite easy. Please stay tuned with me for practical problems of this capital budgeting in the coming videos. If you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe and share these videos with everyone. Be in touch. Have a good, bright future. Good luck. Take care.